Right, hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to paint a cloudy sky and to do this simple landscape. So I've sent you the reference material. Reference material is the photograph. There's the photograph. So you can see I've cropped it right there so that the emphasis can be on the sky. I'm working with three main colors. Ultramarine blue, alizarin crimson, lemon yellow, and I also have a burnt sienna. But to begin with, I'll just start with the primary colors. So I'm going to wet the sky all except for this little light area across the top of the cloud right here. Let's do that. So if you don't wet that area, then the paper will stay dry and the paint won't seep into that area. So when you're at home doing this, you'll work on the flat so that water won't scoot down the page. The important thing is that you wet it twice or three times. It has to be really nice and wet. And you wait at least 5 minutes before you start painting. And before you start painting, that paper has to be shiny where you want it wet. If it's not shiny, if it's matte, then it's dry and it needs more water. Okay, so I'll start with my blue up at the top. And I'm just using my big brush. Notice how I'm using the side of the brush to apply the paint and draw the paint down towards the cloud. So I've made my sky a little bit bigger because I think it'll add more drama to the picture. So as I come to the top of the clouds, I'm going to draw the paint down with the side of my brush. And this will give you a much more natural looking cloud edge rather than going around it like this, which tends to be a very artificial looking cloud. So let's bring some of this blue over here because I'm going to use a sponge, a wet sponge that I've wet and then squeezed out all the extra water to pull off some of this paint. So down to this point here. Now I think I've got a purple mixed up, which is blue and red with a bit of yellow so that it's not too bright. So a bit more paint to that. So put some of this in. Isn't that nice the way that's dripping like that? But we want to do clouds, so just putting a little bit of nice watery paint down here. You have to work quickly so it can dry. So as I get down here, I'm just adding water, which will draw the color down. Let it go into the land. Okay, now you wet your sponge, squeeze out all the water, and then use it to lift off some of your clouds. Smooth that up. So I can't do all those clouds, but it's rather nice the way that slopes down in that direction. So I'm going to pick out some of this. You see that picks up the paint, so you might have to clean off your sponge and squeeze it out again. So let's pick off some of these. So I'm lifting off some of the color, and I want it a little bit lighter down here in the horizon line. To be too dark. Darkest area needs to be up here. So watercolor dries 40% lighter, so you can see my color is quite a lot lighter than when I first applied it. Looking at an angle, and I can see that it's starting to dry in some places and it's still wet in other places, so it's better to just leave it. with skies, the more you fiddle with them, the worse they get. So what we'll do is we'll let it dry, and then we'll apply extra layers of purple to create some of these dark clouds. This, I suggest we just leave that. I know it's not as dark as the picture, but I think it'll be fine. So let's mix up some of this purple, more of the purple. So if your purple's too bright, just add a little bit of yellow into it, a bit more, to be a little bit darker. Now you can see how it's changing from a stronger purple to more of a dull purple. As I add more yellow, it's becoming a little bit duller. So when that's dry, I'm just looking at it on an angle and I can see where it's shiny. It's still shiny there, but it's matte over here, so I can start to work. So I'm going to put some of these shadow area of the clouds and some of this up here. Actually, I think it would look better if it's a bit darker. So I'm going to make that color a bit darker by adding more pigment. There we go, that's better. And that'll make it look a little bit stormier. So you're looking at the shape of those clouds there. So concentrate on the area that you leave. Not so much on what you paint. Notice I'm using the side of my brush again. I'm filling it up with paint. And if you find that you get shapes that you don't like, just use your sponge to take off bits and pieces. And if you've got a hard edge there, you want a soft edge, use your sponge again, and that'll wet the paper, and then you can paint back into it, and that creates a nice soft edge. Come down here because I can do some of this. A bit dark, so I've just lightened my purpley color by adding more water to it. Let's wet that. Sponge. Just gonna wet this so I can come in. It's a little bit easier to paint when it's not quite so bone dry. Alright, so maybe a little bit along here. So you see it's quite nice not doing every single cloud. Picking up on the flavor of it. Let's come down here. So I'm purposely making this area a little bit lighter so that we can develop the darks in the land to get some drama. So put it on, take it off, put it on, take it off. And if you want areas to be even darker, you can add a second layer. So add a little bit more, just a little bit more of this darker pigment. Let's make that a little bit darker. Some more yellow in there. Soften that. Well, this is dry, so I'm adding another layer on top. It's creating a nice edge right there. I want a little bit of purple down here. It's a little bit too bright. So you can play around with that. So when that's dry, you can start painting down here. So we keep the land really nice and simple. So let's start with a yellow wash everywhere except where you want white. So you want just a little sliver of white there and a little bit of white on the front path. Otherwise, we can just put nice light yellow everywhere else. Notice how wet I work. I end up with a little bead of color, and that keeps my wash really nice and fluid. So I want a little bit of white through there, right there, not much. And just go right through the tree. And we'll leave some white on the path. When that dries, then we can go to our next darkest color, which I can see some orange through there and some greens and a little bit of that of purpley, bluey colors. So usually we start background and work to the foreground. So we've laid down a base. Now let's go back and get some purple. So I'm mixing up a bluey purple. Make that bluer, because when something's in the background, it's cooler. So I'm just going to put that on the mountain back there. And I know it's got other colors on there, but you've got to simplify everything to begin with. Okay, so that's that. Let that dry. And if I see any other areas where I might want to make it a bit cooler. But I want this to go back in space. So I'm going to do, this is a shadow coming across from the cloud. So we'll add that at the end. Let's get all the colors underneath first. So now I'm going to do an orange color. These hills, orange color. And you can just leave little strips of yellow. Don't just paint everything the same. Just go right through the tree, because the tree is dark. The trees are all dark, so we want to establish nice light color for the background. I'll make that a bit more of a yellowy orange. Let's see. It's gonna make my, it's a bit too strong. There we go. It's better. Yes. All right, so I've warmed up that midground. So I'm also going to use some of this in the foreground. Just keeping it nice and loose. Nice and watery. I'm just adding a bit of water to my mix. So now let's mix up a green. I need to get some space on my palette. Okay, so I'm also waiting for this to dry. So yellow and blue. Dull green. Let's do that again. That's better. So now let's get some green down this side. So I'm going to leave a little bit of green down here. So I'm just building some areas with some more color. And let's get some green in here. So some areas I've got to leave. Just the yellow on. You can see the yellow's not very bright, so I might add a bit more yellow. That's better. So there's my first layer. I'm going to leave that, let it dry.